You ever gone to the store and spent money that might not have been real? Maybe you have. How would you even know? Hey everyone, thanks for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. If you were living in Mesopotamia in like 3000 BCE, how would you buy things? There are no cards, no ATMs, or cash of any kind. Bartering was a valuable part of any exchange until the invention of international trade. And then money. Money has been made of grains and shells, livestock, beads, and then finally precious metals. The problem is, when we translate the value of something inherently valuable, like a cow or a sack of grain, to something with no actual value, like metal or a piece of paper, people will try to fraudulently jump on that value bandwagon. We call this counterfeiting. And it was so prevalent in the Civil War era that the Secret Service was created to combat it at the time. One third of all US currency in the Civil War era was likely fake. Today it's way less. Currency is in a constant state of cold war with counterfeiters, so science was recruited to help stem that fraud. In 1739, Benjamin Franklin's printing firm created nature prints on colonial banknotes to distinguish them from fakes. Impressions were made on these notes using actual leaves, and the process was so innovative it wasn't even fully understood until centuries later. Today, our money has dozens of these little security additions to verify that our bills are the real deal. Firstly, money isn't regular paper. If someone handed you a perfect reproduction on paper, you would know instantly that it was fake. The paper that we use for money is 75% discarded chunks of blue jeans and 25% linen. It's called rag paper, and it's how you can wash our money and it comes out just fine. The euro is made with 100% cotton, and some other countries don't use paper at all, like Australia, which have used polymer money since 1988. That pen that you sometimes see at the store that they use and they mark the bill with, that's an iodine pen. The iodine reacts with the cellulose differently in regular paper, causing a chemical reaction and a color change, which instantly reveals any counterfeiting. Outside of the paper itself, the inks that they use are also steeped in tech. For example, some euro notes have europium ink. Europium is highly phosphorescent. So under blacklight, the europium ions absorb UV light and then re-release it into the areas of red, green, or blue, depending on the chemistry they used, which is a secret. US notes have phosphorescent inks too, which is how vending machines can spot fakes, plus photocopiers won't print them because of a special reflective ink, which allegedly triggers a halt in the machine. On top of that, some of the lines on American money are actually tiny little words. And there's a watermark, which can't be scrubbed off no matter what you do, and a strip inside of the note, and little red and blue hairs embedded in the paper. All of these are classic money tech. But unfortunately, not everyone looks close enough at their money to really scan all these features. Unfortunately for counterfeiters, they're still working on this. A study in ACS Nano from last year caught the eye of someone at the Treasury Department. The study explored a longhorn beetle that can shift from gold to red as the humidity changes. Inspired by the tiny scales on this beetle, the researchers designed a bleach-resistant photonic crystal ink that can change from green to yellow or red when exposed to ethanol vapor. If you breathe on it, mesoporous silica nanoparticles in the ink absorb minute amounts of the humidity from your breath, thickening them and refracting different colors of light. Imagine if the green trees around the Lincoln Memorial could just turn red and yellow if you breathed on it. Even with all this tech, counterfeiting is still going on. 60% of the $88.7 million seized in 2013 by the Secret Service was printed using at-home inkjet or laser printers. In fact, the first affordable laser printer debuted in 1992, and in 96, the US Treasury committed to the first major redesign of paper money in almost 70 years. Coincidence? I think not. Today, money is redesigned about every 7 years, except for the poor little Washington, the $1 bill. He's not been updated since 1963. The thing is, the United States isn't always fighting Alice in her inkjet. Sometimes countries like North Korea create super bills that can trick even the best detectors. For more on counterfeiting around the world, check out Test Tube News' video on that here.
About 45 million super dollars are thought to be in circulation and bring in an estimated $15 to $25 million a year to North Korea.
Thanks for watching DNews today. Make sure you subscribe so you get more science videos every day of the week. And let us know if you want any other science videos, any ideas you might have, down in the comments.